darkness and put upon us the armor of light. Now in the time of this mortal life in which thy Son, Jesus Christ, came to visit us in great humility, that in the last day when he shall come again in his glorious majesty to judge both the quick and the dead, we may rise to life alone. Through him who liveth and reigneth with thee in the Holy Ghost, one God, now and forever.
Amen. Amen.
Beloved in Christ, in this season let our care and delight be to prepare ourselves and hear again the message of the angels, and in heart and mind to go even unto Bethlehem to see the babe lying in a manger. Let us read and mark in Holy Scripture the tale of the loving purposes of God from the first days of our disobedience unto the glorious redemption brought us by his holy child. And let us look forward to the yearly remembrance of his birth with hymns and songs of praise. But first, let us pray for the needs of this whole world, for peace and goodwill over all the earth, for the mission and unity of the church for which he died, and especially in this country and within this city. And because of all things, would rejoice his heart, let us at this time remember him in his name, the poor and helpless, the hungry and the oppressed, the sick and those who mourn, the lonely and the unborn, the aged and the little children, and all those who know not the Lord Jesus, or who love him not, or who by sin have grieved his heart. Lastly, let us remember before God his pure and holy mother, and all those who rejoice with us, but upon another shore and in greater light, that multitude which no one can number, whose hope was in the Word made flesh, and with whom, in this Lord Jesus, forevermore are one. These prayers and praises let us humbly offer to the throne of heaven. In the words of Christ himself will start us. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power,
the Almighty God bless us with this grace. Christ, give us the joys of everlasting life. Into the fellowship of the citizens above, may kings of angels bring us all.
The Lord called to the man and said to him, "Where are you?"
Glenn said, "The woman whom you gave to be with me, she gave me free fruit from the tree, and I ate." Then the Lord God said to the woman, "What is this that you have done?" The woman said, "The serpent tricked me, and I ate." The Lord God said to the serpent, "Because you have done this, curses are you among all animals and among all wild creatures. Upon your belly you shall go, and dust you shall eat all the days of your life. I will put enmity between you and the woman, and between your offspring and hers. He will strike her head, and you will strike his heel."
Have seen a great light. Those who have lived in a land of deep darkness on them, light has shined. For a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish and uphold it with justice and with righteousness from this time onward and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord hosts will do this. Here ends the lesson.
The third lesson, God comforts his people and calls on them to prepare for redemption. Comfort my people, says your God. Speak tenderly to Jerusalem and cry to her that she has served her term, that the penalty is paid, that she has received from the Lord's hand double for all her sins. A voice cries out, in the wilderness prepare the way of the Lord. Make straight in the desert highway for our God. Every valley shall be lifted up, and every mountain and hill be made low. The uneven ground shall become level, and the rough places a plain. Then the glory of the Lord shall be revealed, and all the people shall see it together. For the mouth of the Lord has spoken. Here ends the lesson.
Do not let your hands grow weak. The Lord your God is in your midst, a warrior who gives victory. He will rejoice over you with gladness. He will renew you in his love. He will exalt over you with loud singing on a day of festival. I will remove disaster from you so that you no longer bear reproach from it.
And of his kingdom there will be no end. Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I am a virgin?" The angel said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be holy. He will be called Son of God." Then Mary said, "Here am I, the servant of the Lord. Let it be with me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her. Here ends the lesson.
Thank you. Sixth lesson, John the Baptist is born, and his father rejoices that his son will prepare the way of the Lord. The time came for Elizabeth to give birth, and she bore a son. Her neighbors and relatives heard that the Lord had shown his great mercy to her, and they rejoiced with her. On the eighth day, they came to circumcise the child, and they were going to name him Zechariah after his father. But his mother said, "No, he is to be called John." They said to her, "None of your relatives have this name." Then they began motioning to his father to find out what name he wanted to give him. He asked for a writing tablet and wrote, "His name is John." And all of them were amazed. Immediately his mouth was opened and his tongue free, and he began to speak, praising God. Fear came over their neighbors, and all these things were talked about throughout the entire hill country of Judea. All who heard them pondered them and said, "What then will this child become? For indeed, the hand of the Lord was with him." Then his father Zechariah was filled with Holy Spirit and spoke this prophecy, "Blessed be the Lord God of Israel, for he has looked favorably on his people and redeemed them. The child grew and became strong in spirit, and he was in the wilderness until the day he appeared publicly to Israel." Here ends the lesson.
Thank you. that when thy Son, our Lord, cometh, may find in us the mansion prepared for himself. Through the same Jesus Christ, our Lord, who liveth and reigneth with thee in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Thank you.
watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news for great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah of the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly hosts, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth, peace among those whom he favors." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in the manger. Here ends the lesson.
He came to what was his own,
and his own people did not accept him. But to all who received him, who believed in his name, he gave power to become children of God, who were born not of blood or the will of the flesh or of the will of man, but of God. And the Word became flesh and lived among us. And we have seen his glory, the glory as a Father's only Son, full of grace and truth. Here it is.
Thank you.
Bless you in this holy season. Scatter the darkness of sin and brighten your heart with the light of his holiness.
Amen.
May God, who sent his angels to proclaim the glad news of the Savior's birth, fill you with joy and make you heralds of the gospel.
Amen.
May God, who in the Word made flesh, join heaven to earth and earth to heaven, give you his peace and favor.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit rest and abide with you, now and forever.
Amen.
Let us go forth in peace, in the name of Christ.
Amen.